Oh, Minerva, you're back! Seth, wake up!
Why did she hang me here next to you?
Don't lie, you love it.
What is it, Elbus?
I just got word. Ginny Potter had her baby.
Oh, that's lovely. What's she called?
Elbus, what's their daughter called?
Her first name is Lily.
Middle name?
Luna.
Well, that means you don't have to be dead. Okay, next name?
Potter.
That's it.
Oh, it's so rude, isn't it? Aren't you so mad?
No, not at all.
What would there be in an Albus?
Severus.
Potter. Seems real ironic when Severus bullied him and I just raised him to die. When you got him that expensive broom, got him on the Quidditch team, said he wasn't a piece of meat, generally cared about him.
That's gotta hurt.
What a betrayal! How do you feel?
I'm fine.
She doesn't look fine.
No, she looks crazy.
Can someone please get me to the hospital? If you need to know, my blood type is red.
Here's the reason I don't care that I can't do a handstand or splits. I was 11 years old when I started in the most phenomenally successful franchise of all time. I have some of the greatest British actors of all time on my speed dial on my phone. I have Gary Oldman, Alan Rickman, Maggie Smith, Danny Dyer. I have Danny Dyer on my f***ing phone.
Yeah, but can you do this?
I'm gonna call him.
No, you're not there at all. Come on.
We're doing the same thing, Jake. I have kissed Emma Watson. I'm the most famous person you've ever been near. Jake, you made me feel so inadequate! All I have to do now is learn my lines, go through several elaborate costume fittings, go through makeup and hair, and speak to the producers a couple of times, then speak to my agents several times, and we'll be ready. So, let's go to the studio.
It represents so much what we've been doing for the last 7 or 8 years, so emotions are coming easy, which is great for the scene.
Draco!
Draco is the first one of the good guys to sort of come over, so lots of evil glares for everyone around me. But obviously I don't really have a choice. My dad's sort of clicking his fingers saying, here, here.
Draco.
When it comes to the crunch, Lucius wants his son to stay alive, and he is distraught at the thought that Draco might rather die than join the Death Eaters.
He's in turmoil, really. He doesn't quite know where the good side is the right side to be on. But unfortunately, his father and his mother take pull rank with him and pull him over back to the evil side. So, much to his unfavourable distaste, I'm sure he gets dragged back into Voldemort's side.
In the end, Draco and Narcissa, they don't really see themselves as being much use, so they go and let the battle commence, really. So, yeah, flee to safety.
You can say what you like, Lucia, I wouldn't die for you. I'm down on my knees and I need you to be my God, be my help.
Say yeah, I say no. When you say so.